look so good. See,
come on.
Why would this kid that I raised up be such an idiot? I think that's what Pharaoh was probably thinking. How stupid. What happened to you? What happened to you between Egypt and the desert? See, a lot of people don't understand that you learn a lot in the desert. God really speaks to you when you're alone. When you feel like you have got nothing left.
Thank you.
If thou wilt save Israel by my hand, as I have said, behold, I will put a fleece wool in for it. Now, the thing is, God can give you a word, but if you don't embrace the word. See, there's people in this building today that you are sitting with something that has been birthed in you. That if it don't get out of you, it's going to kill you. You are going to die trying to birth this thing because you cannot birth it. Because you're sitting here saying, I don't know if I can. You need to challenge yourself. I thank God for this afternoon service. Amen. I thank God for those women that said, we're going to get together. And we're going to begin to do something that's been sitting still. It's been sitting still too long. We've been sitting on our hands too long. We've let the devil come and tell us that we can't have a ministry in our life. And it be dry upon all the earth beside. Then shall I know that thou wilt save Israel by mine hand, as thou hast said. Lord, I just need to know. I need some evidence. Nothing wrong with that, Brother Mark. Nothing wrong with saying, God, you know, do something so I know. But the thing is, just knowing it's not enough, you've got to embrace it. Because he went all the way through the chapters here, and he said, and it's so for he rose up early on the morrow and thrust the fleece together and wringed the dew out of the fleece, a bowl full of water. And Gideon said unto God, let not thine anger be hot against me. So that lets you know something, church. That just because God answers the first time doesn't mean that your flesh is not so weak that it won't ask again. But my Bible says, if you ask, you shall receive. But as I say again, just asking is not enough. You've got to step into action. You've got to say that we are going to be delivered because the Lord God is with us. Church, you can't step back and say because the Lord didn't show up this week that he hasn't showed up. Because God is arranging something bigger. You're just going to be fixed for the moment. God said, I got a bigger plan than that. I see you sitting in a different office. I see you maturing so you can be the one, amen, that will help to build the work that I'm wanting to do. But you don't understand. You see a small perception of it. But I see, amen, I see men more than just trees. I see something more than what you did. See, you're only perceiving what you're perceiving. But I want you to get some evidence here that I'm bigger than all your problems. Touch people's lives, it'll be evident you have a